Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today we'll be understanding the difference between artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, and data science. These all are big buzzwords, right? But knowing when to use which one is quite important. So let's break it down. Number one, data science. Now, data science is all about data, and I'm pretty sure that you already knew that. We all know that every single tech company out there is collecting huge amount of data from us. And the data in 21st century is regarded as revenue. Why is that? That's because of data science. The more data that you have, the more business insights you can generate. Using data science, you can uncover patterns in data that you didn't even knew existed. For example, you can discover that some guy who went to New York City for a vacation is most likely to splurge on a luxury trip to Venice in the next 3 weeks. And if you're a company offering luxury tours to exotic destinations, you might be interested in getting this guy's contact number. Just like this, companies are using data science to build recommendation engines, predicting user behavior, and doing so much more. And all of this is only possible when you have enough amount of data to get accurate results that can be applied to a business use case. Next, there's also something called as prescriptive analytics, which pretty much does the same predictions that we talked about in the rich tourist example above. But as an added benefit, prescriptive analytics will also tell you what kind of luxury tours to Venice a person might be interested in. For example, one person might want to fly first class but would be fine with a 3-star hotel, whereas another person could be ready to fly economy but definitely needs the most luxurious stay and cultural experience of Venice. So even though both these people will be your rich clients, both of them have different requirements. So in this scenario, prescriptive analytics will help you a lot. You might be wondering, hey, that sounds a lot like artificial intelligence, and you're not entirely wrong actually. Let's see how. Number 2, artificial intelligence. So, artificial intelligence, or AI for short, is the ability that can be imparted to computers which enable these machines to understand data, learn from data, and make decisions based on patterns hidden in the data, or inferences that could be otherwise be very difficult or almost impossible for humans to make manually. AI also enables machines to adjust their knowledge based on new inputs that were not a part of data used for training these machines. But there's one thing you need to make sure, that you have enough data for AI to learn from. If you have very small data lake that you are using to train your AI model, the accuracy of the prediction or significance of the decision made could be very low. So do understand that more the data, better is the training of the AI model and more accurate will be the outcome. Depending on the size of training data, you can choose various algorithms for your model, and this is where machine learning and deep learning start to show up. Number 3, machine learning. Machine learning, or ML, is considered as a subset of AI. You can even say that ML is an implementation of AI, so whenever you think of AI, you can think of applying ML there. As the name makes it pretty clear, machine learning is used in situations where we want the machine to learn from huge amount of data we give it, and then apply that knowledge on new pieces of data that is streamed into the system. But now you might be thinking, how does a machine learn? Well, there are different ways of making a machine learn. These broadly include supervised learning, non-supervised learning, semi-supervised learning, and reinforced machine learning. In some of these methods, a user tells a machine what are the features or independent variables, or to state simply, inputs, and which are the dependent variables or outputs. So a machine learns the relationship between independent variable and dependent variable present in the data that is provided to the machine. This data which is provided to the machine is called training set. And once the training phase or the training is complete, the machine or the ML model is tested on a piece of data that model has not encountered before. This new data set is called test data. Now on comparing actual results with the one we got from the model, we gain how accurately the machine has learned. There are many types of models and algorithms that can be employed to do this, and I have created a short 5-minute video to help you get familiar with the basics, link for which is given in the description below, so be sure to check it out. Moving forward, do note that there is a lot of data preparation or pre-processing steps that you need to take care of even before training your model. But ML libraries such as scikit-learn have evolved so much that even an app developer without any background in mathematics or statistics, or even a candidate with a formal AI education, can start using these libraries to build, train, test, deploy and use machine learning models in real world. But do note that it is always helpful to know how these algorithms work, as they will help you to make informed decisions when you are to select an algorithm for your problem statement. With this knowledge of ML, let's talk a bit about deep learning now. Number 4. Deep learning. Deep learning, or DL, is an advancement of ML and is regarded as a subset of machine learning. And while ML is a superpower for most applications, there are situations where ML leaves a lot to be desired. That is where deep learning steps in. It is generally believed that if your training dataset is relatively small, you go with machine learning. But if you have a huge amount of data on which you can train models, and if the data has too many features along with accuracy being super important in your case, you can take the deep learning route. It is also important to note that deep learning requires much powerful hardware to run. That's why mostly GPUs are used, and it takes significantly more time to train your models. And it is generally more difficult to implement as compared to ML. But these are some of the compromises that you have to live with when the problem you are trying to solve is that much more complex. Also, you might have heard of TensorFlow, which is a neural network that Google is extensively using and pushing to developers. Lastly, don't forget that it is this future advancement of deep learning that today we have vision of building self-driving cars, or are even able to use complex tools like Google Translate that are able to translate big paragraph of text from one language to another in a matter of milliseconds. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, be sure to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to the channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.